We bow before your throne. We bow before your throne. Worship at your feet. Glory, host God. We bow before your throne. Oh, glory, host, glory, host God. Beautiful, beautiful. Excellent, excellent, good. We bow before your throne. What a wonderful Savior we have. He's a glorious God. He's El Shaddai. He's Elohim. He's a creator that we are not created. He's the God that created heaven and earth. He's the Almighty. He have no competitor. He have no rival. No one you will use to compare Jehovah, the giver of life, our sustainer, the author and the finisher of our faith, the beginning and the end in his name. He told in the book of Exodus, he told Moses, go and tell Pharaoh, my name is I am that I am. And he never changed. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever, according to the book of Hebrew. He is the same God. He never changed. He remains who he is. Welcome back again to Ade TV, everyone. I hope you are doing good. May the Lord do us good in Jesus' name. Today, I have a short broadcast in the name of Jesus. A little word of encouragement. We should know, as I said last time, there is not much time to waste. We should encourage ourselves, whatever we are passing through. We should know that this world is not our home. We are passing by. Have it in mind. Whatever you are holding, please don't hold it tight with your right hand. Hold it with your left hand. In case of anything, give it away. Give that in a way. Focus in heaven so that you will not be distracted. Whatsoever that would take away your focus, because the word of God says, if any man put hand in a plow, look back, is not worthy. It's a self-denial. This heavenly race is a personal race. Deny yourself before the Lord. We must deny ourselves. Self-denial. Because if you love, the Bible says, if you love, our Lord Himself was saying, if you love your parents, your husband, anything more than Him, you are not worthy. You know we serve a jealous God. He loves us, and no one can die for us except Him. He has done it all for our sake. He renounced Himself, He passed through agony for you and me to come to the knowledge of truth, to come to the salvation of our Lord Jesus, giving all, paying the precious, using a precious life, with man without sin, without no any stain. Because of our sin, He used His blood, the holy blood, to cleanse us, to wash us. That is to be clean, I mean. That is why He came to this head and carry human body and come and die for us. No matter what you believe, you might be Muslim, you might be Buddhist, you might be whatsoever. You might also be unbeliever. It doesn't matter. One day, me and you will face our Maker. Have you ever seen that and think, what? How? Are you going to face this God? What are you going to tell Him that day? I do it. What are you going to face Him with that day? It's really, really terrible. Because in your satellite that He used to watch us, He never have blink. He never blink. He never said that. You know those days when we watch, when we used to use video. Video cassette. When you put it, it will be doing, give you some sign that the video will be a long time. But our Lord God video, it doesn't have a long time because He's ancient of this. He zooms us from heaven to here on earth. He search everything about us. We must be careful in this weird world we have. We must be careful when we are doing things. We are not serving man. We are serving the Creator that knows everything about us, that search our hearts, that is not a respecter of any man. All He needs from us, pure inside and outside, total pureness, total holiness. That is what the Lord needs from us. Yes, a trial will come and really try our holiness, to come and try our faith. But the Bible says, look unto the Lord Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Okay? Before we do that, let's look to the book of Luke. We are reading quickly. Luke 13:24. It says, strive to enter into the narrow gate. This is the word of our Lord Jesus, because when he's written with the red pen, it means that is our Lord is speaking direct. This place is saying that many will be desire to enter, but they will not be able to enter. Depends on your decision. Who are you surrendered to? Please read it well. Luke 13:24. Narrow is the gate. You must strive to enter into this narrow gate. Say, strive to enter. Strive. You must try. The last time my broker said that is a narrow way. You must shaping up yourself before you enter. Now strive. You are going to strive. You are going to remove everything on your way so that you can be able to enter to this narrow gate. Narrow is the gate that lead to heaven. Narrow is the gate that lead to the world with our Lord Jesus. Narrow is the gate that lead to holiness. Narrow. Narrow is so narrow. Many will desire to enter. That is why in the churches today, you don't need to walk in multitude with few. If it is 10 people, 5 people that be able to grab the word of the pastor, the holy living, the righteous living, the truth the pastor is saying, please, pastor, let that individual walk on them. It's better than leading to multitude to hell that is not saved, that fighting, that bringing trouble, bringing a lot of calamity in the church today. We have to strive to enter. Narrow is the gate. It's so narrow. It's not a broad way. The way to heaven. The way of salvation. The way the Lord, our Lord Jesus came to show us here on earth. It's so narrow. It's a narrow road. We must prepare according to the standard of heaven so that we can be able to go there. We must prepare. That is the word I have to say today. Please, we have to arrange ourselves. We have to work on ourselves so badly. We have to work on ourselves seriously. We have to call upon the name of the Lord to help us, because we cannot do it on our own. We have no power of our own. He's the one that is helping us. He's the one that helping us. All you need is to surrender all. Now you tell the Lord, I give up to you. Use me the way that pleases you. Do what pleases you in my life. At the end, your name alone will be glorified, not of me, but of the Lord. We are nothing before the Lord. We are just human vapor. What you see today, you might not see it again tomorrow. That is just the life we have. But the word of God remains sure. The word of God can never be broken. The word of God can never be broken. That is why preparation is really matter. As we all, we are here in Europe, we are going to your country. You have to prepare. You have to buy tickets. You have to take some days to arrange yourself. This is what you want. If it's a place of cold, you have to have some new jackets or some clothes, shoes that will fit to that place. That is how heaven is. Heaven don't need some kind of yamanyama thing. It don't need some kind of adornment. It don't need some kind of attitude we are doing. We have to tell the Lord to teach us the way. We have to tell the Lord to lead us through to this narrow way so that we will not miss it at the end. That is just all. We have to call upon him, because the Bible says already we should not lean on our own understanding. In all our way, we should acknowledge him. We should call upon him to order our step daily. As we do, he will help us. Even our going and coming in, we commit everything into the hands of the living God. What we see, we'll come back victorious in everything we have done without even pollution in our hearts. That is it, my brethren. Friend and family, may the Lord help us to prepare in this narrow way in the name of Jesus. Daddy, many have called in your word, few have chosen. Make me, my family, the people are there to be among the few you will choose. And I will be with you in eternity in the name of Jesus. Anything in us that don't make us to be worthy. Father, we pray for shaping us, because narrow is the way that leads to heaven. Narrow is the way that leads to the road of righteousness. Father, help us to be pure in our hearts. Help us, those hidden things in our life that will hinder us, may you take them away from us in Jesus' name. Those anger, those little forces, according to the book of Solomon, those little forces that square the vine, uproot them away from us, remove them from our lives, so that we will be pure and holy in our hearts in the name of Jesus. So that day you will accept us according to your will, according to our holy living and righteous living here on earth, in the name of Jesus. Any spot in our life, we sprinkle the blood of Jesus. Oh Lord, make our garments pure and holy, like the day you give in to us from the beginning, in the name of Jesus. To you be all praise and honor. Bless every soul that will listen to this word. Let it not be a judgment to any one of us. Let it not stand against me. Let it not stand against everyone. Let it be a revival and quickening to our soul in the name of Jesus. Lord, we love you because you are our Savior. Because you first love us and choose us. May your name be glorified today. All are going and coming. Have your way and take charge in our lives. In Jesus' blessed, victorious, excellent name we are praying. Amen. God bless you, my beloved. May the Lord be with you all in Jesus' name.